ready for a lot of us. But they're not calming down at all. In fact, for some of you, they're getting worse. So here's where, in the past 24 hours, we've seen some of the top wind gusts. Very windy around the Great Lakes. Steph was talking about all the issues with water getting moved from Lake Michigan there. We've had very strong winds through the Appalachians in the Northeast. But now as we look forward in time, we're going to see some strong winds actually continuing to build today through the Mid-Atlantic, maybe even worse than yesterday. Top winds so far, Provincetown 90, Wellfleet 89. And, you know, it's been out there towards the Cape. We stick out. That's where we've had some of the strongest of the winds, but a very large and strong wind field with this cyclone. So get ready. We've got a wind advisory up for a good chunk of the area. That's the bright purple. The darker purple are high wind warnings right here along the coast, the Jersey Shore, parts of the tri-state. A high wind warning for today. You're going to see those traffic lights blowing in the wind. You're not going to be able to find your trash can if you put the trash out last night. That's, you know, a couple blocks away. Winds 40 to 50 miles per hour, pretty widespread right through the afternoon. I mean, that's a strong wind field. I mean, we're talking, you know, strong tropical storm force like winds today. Not that we're going to have any rain, but we are going to see the wind continue in D.C. even this evening, still 30 to 35 miles per hour. You know, at this point, trees, you know, having to take this wind now for more than 24 hours. There might be some tree limbs coming down. We might have some more power outages to deal with. By this evening and early tomorrow morning, winds start to relax to about 15 to 20 miles per hour. Still not calm, right? That's going to take through the day tomorrow to get those winds calm. New York, Atlantic City, Harrisburg, that'll be tomorrow evening for you. Meantime, it is just blasting south of Boston. Listen to this. With all the weather, Mike, it's hard to see how we're not going to have that. Let's bring in the plane. I'm going to show you some of the airports that we're keeping an eye on, unfortunately. We're literally watching every single hub in the Northeast for the possibility of delays. The rain is one thing, not the biggest thing. The wind is the biggest issue out there, and that's just affecting so many. It's so widespread. Still windy in Buffalo and Cleveland and Erie and Philly and D.C. And, you know, I'm going to put Harrisburg and Reading and Allentown in there as well. I mean, all these points in between Baltimore, New York City, all the hubs here, Boston expecting delays with the wind that we have out here today. So let's go ahead and take a look at where the aircraft are right now as we look out over the airspace. You can get a sense of how these flights are arriving too, coming in to the east. You know, we've got a lot of planes in the air. There is going to be some turbulence as well up here, especially across northern New England today. Already a look out at that potential based on some of the outlooks for pilots out there today. But I want to focus in on the wind and that wind direction from the west southwest at JFK. So we've zoomed into the JFK airport. We're expecting winds to gust 40 to 50 miles per hour today. We've got two runways that run just like this, running from the northwest to the southeast. So this is pretty much going to be a crosswind. Now, one of these runways is already closed for construction, but the best runway at JFK, the longest one, is going to have a crosswind from this today. So that's going to cut down on their use of that one. That's going to affect arrivals there. Philadelphia, let's take a look at your runway set up here over the area. Winds west, southwest, or south. Southwest mainly today, 35 to 40. They might shift a little more to the west. But when you look at the runway setup, that is going to be a crosswind for this runway right here. And to some extent, this runway stuff, but I think overall, they'll be just heading into, landing that way into the wind here in Philadelphia.
How they like to do it.
And if you're traveling on the roads, the wind is going to be a factor. You'll feel it. Your car will be buffeted. You're like, oh, you know, this is a two-hand on the wheel kind of day, not like hold your coffee with one hand and try to drive with the other. Winds gusting at 35 miles per hour right now around New York City, Hartford 21, Providence gusting to 37, and that will be a crosswind for any of you traveling on 395. It's going to be much of a tailwind for you on 95 if you're traveling from south to north. Now, let's talk about what's going on in New York City weather-wise today. Rainfall, we're not going to see much. It's not impossible to get a shower, but that's not going to be your main weather today. It's all about the wind, mainly cloudy, some breaks in the clouds, the sun will peek out every once in a while, kind of day. A lot of stratocumulus clouds. Temperatures hang out in the 50s. It's going to feel colder because of the wind. Probably feel like the upper 40s. Now, there is still some rain chances a little farther north, and we'll see that here in the Hartford area. Expecting delays on the roads because of some maybe trees down, power lines could be down. And there are some schools either closed or going in on delays here in Connecticut today. Steph and Jim. Well, if you watch more about some other cities, though, that will get the rain, and you would go over to Gainesville, Florida. You know, because it's so lopsided, we're going to see the rain and some of the wind on the east side. And it's really, I think, more rain and thunderstorms than anything else. We may get to wind gusts potentially up over 30, 35, potentially 50 to 60 miles per hour. But I think overall, this is going to be a rainmaker, a thunderstorm maker. And we know thunderstorms can be a bit fierce. And that's, you know, what we will see with this potential tropical cyclone as it moves in. Now, one thing I need to point out with this wind field right now, if you know, this is a, you know, just a model look, really. The circulation here, circulation here. It's just a model rendition of what's going on right now, but that's very accurate because there are multiple tiny little circulations. We need to get one to take over as the main circulation before you can really call this Nestor. Now, as we watch the wind field, though, and watch it ramp up through the day today, we'll see those winds continuing to pick up along the coast. Wind gusts over 30, 35, 40, 45 miles per hour are possible. Again, moving quick, so this is Saturday morning, and now we look at that center of circulation and we look at those gusty winds coming on shore, but they move through pretty quick. And so as we go through the day on Saturday, we will see things calm down pretty quickly in terms of the overall wind field. All right, let's look at the risk for storm surge. We've got a 3 to 5 foot storm surge potential. This would be your reasonably worst case scenario. We see that from Apalachicola, Indian Pass, points east over here towards Cedar Key, and then coming just down here towards Clearwater, there's the potential for 2 to 4 foot of storm surge. Steph?
Well, one of the places, just like, oh, sorry, that just.
Those boats aren't cheap.
That pains us. No, I guess that's
there.
What insurance is for, right?
That's right.
All right,
that's
let's have a look at our turbulence reports and what we are going to be dealing with. And wow, there we go. Flights still coming in and out of the Northeast. I haven't seen any delays. I actually looked just before the show here, which is good news, especially with all the wind that we have here. Everything is green, but remember, it's 6 o'clock in the morning. This is when flights just start taking off. So here's a look at nationally where we already have delays and cancellations for us across the board. Kennedy, Boston has the most cancellations, already 50 canceled flights. So that's the other trick that these airlines do. You won't see a lot of delays because they'll just cancel half the flights. And then they'll have no problem with the, you know, quarter or maybe a third of the flights that get off. So today, you know, we will see impact at the airports. As we head into tomorrow, things will be much improved for our Friday, which is good news because so many people travel on Friday. I-95 will be fine for us here as we head through the day with no rain, but wind, Jen, will still be a problem.
Now, let's go south.